So if I seem a little wobbly today, it's because I'm sitting on the cat's scratching post. And the reason for that is, I don't know if you remember in the last couple of videos when I bent down to look into my mirror, my magnifying mirror is sort of a concave, so I have to get right in the center of it to see, which, like when I was dyeing my eyebrows last week, by the way, still super pleased about that, I was hiding behind the mirror and you couldn't see anything. So I thought, what I need is to be above the mirror so I can look down into the mirror and have the camera up above the mirror. And then I thought, well, in order to do that, I need to buy like a bar stool to sit on. And then I thought, well, before I buy a bar stool to sit on, shouldn't I assess whether that actually works? So I'm sitting on the cat's scratching post with a blanket thrown over it. So I'm a little wobbly. And it's gonna be one of those videos. Okay, yesterday I tested out the Glitz LED phototherapy or light therapy mask, and then I used it again today for 20 minutes. So if you wanted to see what the results are the next day, I feel like it's looking better just in, sit still. I feel like it's looking better just in one day. I don't know, but it feels like the swelling has gone down. It feels like this is flatter and less inflamed, and so are these. And I am getting ready to shoot another video today. So I thought, well, why not just hang out and get ready with you? And now we've been talking for a while and I haven't done a darn thing, so walk and talk, Monique. I'll get some primer on. This is the Amazing Cosmetics Anti-Aging Primer. We've had a little bit of rain in Southern California. It is so nice to have sunshine again today, even though more rain is coming. One of the things I hate when it's rainy, my apartment doesn't really get a lot of light in here, so then I rely entirely on the lights. But what happens is the light that comes in from my window is really dark and depressing, and my background is all gray. And whenever I shoot a video on a rainy day, I'm like, God, that looks depressing. I wouldn't want to live there. And it's just the way the light comes in on a rainy day. And so it's nice to have sunshine and some light coming in to the room. There, now I have vamped long enough while the primer has sunk into my skin a little bit. So yeah, lots of rain lately. In fact, if you've seen the news, there was talk about a sinkhole that opened up in Studio City. And I live in Studio City, and that sinkhole is just down the street from me. It's a couple of blocks away. It is so close. How scary would that be? Can you imagine driving along and all of a sudden the ground falls out from under your car? And next thing you know, you are 10, 11 feet down from the street in running water looking up. I mean, what a horrific thing to happen. Can you imagine? I am using my Makeup Forever Ultra HD Y235, and I'm going to apply it with my It Cosmetics brush. I'm not sure if this is really an appropriate brush for applying foundation, but I really like how soft it is and the texture of it, and I've never applied foundation with it, and I want to try for no reason, just to try, because I'm like that. I know, it always looks too light when I first put it on, doesn't it? And then once you blend it in, it's like, oh no, that is right. But when I first put it on, it's like, that's not right. like this as a applicator brush. It does hold a lot of product, I think, but I feel like it really has a lot of fine hairs that really feathers that out. When was the last time we really caught up? I had a great Valentine's Day. It was fun to have a boyfriend on Valentine's Day, and we didn't go out. We stayed in and ordered Chinese food, and he gave me some pretty sexy shoes and some pretty sexy other things that I don't need to share with you on film. No, he gave me stockings. Really, it's not that provocative. It sounded good. Sometimes you realize that being mysterious sounds way more mysterious than you really meant for it to be. One thing I do like about this brush is when I sort of like tap, it does a nice job blending. Amazing Cosmetics in Light Golden. Joe Blasco Orange Highlight 1. And a little of my e.l.f. High Def Powder. I use the translucent, the colorless. Sequel. Please, baby. Yeah, if you want to sit in the drawer, that's fine. You can totally sit in the drawer. That's cool. Just, you know, shh. Okay. So we had the massive rain this weekend, and the boyfriend and I decided that we were just not going to brave the storm, and we settled in for the weekend. And it was our first weekend of just sort of cozying in and watching TV and doing nothing, and we sent him out for Chinese food again. And we did go out when it wasn't raining, and ran a few errands, and, you know, had a meal and a couple of meals, and it was just a really nice chill out weekend. And it's been a long time since I had one of those, so I really enjoyed it. Naked Flushed for a little tiny bit of bronzer and then a little bit of blush. Just a smidge of highlighter. The same flushed, Naked Flushed palette. Elf primer. I mentioned I dyed my eyebrows a few days ago. Was it a week ago? And I used the Refectosil. So happy with it. I cannot tell you how pleased I am. If you've followed along on my videos, you know that I have been on the quest to find the perfect gray eyebrow, and I have finally found it, and I love that I don't have to wear as much eye pencil. In fact, having gone all weekend without makeup, this is my first day wearing eye pencil since dyeing my eyebrows. So, we'll see how much I like it. Okay, hardly any, just using feather light strokes. Oh, so much more pleased with it. It looks so much more natural. Yikes. Very pleased. And I'm hoping that when I can see my eyebrows, that you can see my eyebrows. And I won't know that until I edit this, so. Let's find out. Well, probably not. That might be too low, and that might still be too low. The only really bad thing about having the mirror below me is that I keep doing this. And we all know what happens when you keep doing that. You just show like this all part that you don't really want to. So that's sort of a bummer. I suppose I could bring it up higher. So much to learn. Part of me just doesn't even want to put eyeshadow on. And I don't know if that's a choice or just laziness, because you know I get really, really lazy about things like that. Smashbox palette. I know I love that. Whee! I'm so easily entertained. And this is my big poofy brush. It's, I think, a number, I have no idea, from Royal and Langnickel. I mostly remembered that. And this is sort of the vanilla-ish color in this palette. So in case you're working with a similar palette or similar tones, this is really like a yellowy buttercream vanilla. Diffused Crease Brush by Sigma, and I'm going to go in with this super light milk chocolate. Thank you. I always seem to get this eye a little darker. I don't know why. It must be the angle that I hold my hand. But it also just always goes on darker on that eye. Don't you love how I say it goes on darker as though I had nothing to do with it? Obviously, it's something that I am doing, clearly. I want to put on a color, but this palette has so much fallout, I don't feel like doing cleanup. I have a dark green NYX liner pen, and I'm not terribly good at this, but we'll give it a go. A lot of people write to me and ask me about doing a winged eyeliner. Is it appropriate for women after 50? Is it advised? How do I do it? And the answer to all of that is, I love a winged eyeliner, and if you can see your eyes well enough and get the wrinkles to stay in one spot after 50, you rock that look, but I'm not having any luck with that. I can't see well enough to do a good winged liner. They always come out lopsided. It always seems like I get following a fold in the skin and it's a wrinkle and it just doesn't look right. And love a winged eyeliner, can't do it. I'm gonna throw on lashes and call it a day. Another question a lot of people ask me, in a lot of my videos, you see that I don't put anything on the bottom. No mascara, no eyeliner, nothing. And people ask, why? Why do you do it on some days and why not on others? And the entire reason for that is, yeah, it's just my mood. Some days I feel like it, some days I don't. Some days I don't know whether I'm gonna put anything on the bottom lashes until I'm at that stage. In fact, that's pretty normal for me. This is L'Oreal Voluminous in Blackest Black. And I am now at the stage where I must decide, do I want to put mascara on my lower lashes or not? And the simple fact is, the top lashes need to dry, so we're gonna put that off while we put on some lips. I went with a fairly subdued eye, so that means I can do a strong lip. Up until now, I have had on the Wet n Wild Mega Slicks Balm Stain in number 126, Rico Mauve. Okay, I know it says Rico Mauve, but I know what they wanted to say was Rico Mauve. And now I am going to put on my Revlon Matte Balm in Fiery. This has been my favorite lately. For winter 2017, this has been my favorite lip color to wear. We'll be right back. want to add a lip liner and give that a more definition. Let me see what I have. So wobble off the cat's scratching post. Colby's going, where am I supposed to sit? I grabbed the NYX lip pencil in mauve. Do we put mascara on the lower lashes or not? Generally, I'd say no, but you know, since I built it up, I'm gonna do it, and I'll let you look at both eyes and you can see what you think is best. So what's your vote? Do you like the look better with mascara on the bottom lashes? Or without? They're kind of both fine. Neither one is better. They're just different. And that's why sometimes I don't put anything on the bottom. It's just different. It's just sometimes I like that look. That's all. What's your thing? Do you have a thing that you do where everyone says you should do blah, 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 and you're like, yeah, no, blah, blah, blah doesn't work for me. I'm not thinking blah, blah, blah. I'm thinking whatever other noise. You know what I mean. What's your thing? You have a thing? We all have a thing. I'm now committed to wearing mascara on the bottom lashes because I'm not going to take it off. I'll show you the dress that I have on today. This is a dress that I have had for... Isn't it terrible that I remember everything by where I was living and I was married then? So that means it was over 11 years ago. I lived in Ventura. And that means this dress is probably 12 years old, 13 years old. And I hardly ever wear it because it's silk and silk always shows every drop of perspiration. But it's still winter, the weather's cool, so this is the time I wear silk. Not sure how much you can see back here, but it's just a basic dress. Nothing fancy, but I do love my new shoes. Jewelry is a gift from a girlfriend who I am trying to talk into opening her up her own place to sell jewelry and stuff for Etsy or Facebook or something, and she's still in the gotta twist her arm phase. So, in case anyone has any questions about my jewelry, that's the answer on that. What else? Oh yeah, my hair. I just threw a ponytail and then took that extension piece that I had from Halloween and put it on and just wrapped it around and stuck some pins in it. I have noticed one interesting thing with my hair recently. It seems to be getting darker. It's just the strangest thing. It just looks like it's getting darker. It looks like it's getting blonder. I know it's like silver gray, but now it's like I'm starting to see blonde hairs in it, and I don't know if it's just the length that it's getting to, or it's just very interesting to watch your hair suddenly start changing color on you. And it's probably because it's winter time and I'm not out as much. And when the time comes that I'm out hiking all the time, it'll get back in the sun and bleach out a little bit. I don't know. This is the first time in my life I've had my natural hair color, so I'm still learning the cycles that it goes through throughout the year. Do you have that? Does your hair change color naturally throughout the year? I'd be really interested to find out if that's something that other silver-haired women go through. It's all new for me. I hope you have an awesome rest of your day, and I love you bunches. Please give me a thumbs up. Drop your comments down below, and if you haven't subscribed already, please do so. I will talk to you very soon.